was I made software for mapping gestures to music using MIDI messages. Digital music is a really prevalent thing in all forms of music now, whether it's recording, production, performance, whatever. There are many aspects of digital music in play. And we have conventional controllers for interacting with those things. So you might have something like knob, right? Or faders or whatever to control those things. But sometimes those can lack some amount of expressivity, expression, transparency, intuitiveness. I want to be able to move my arm, move something freely, and have that control the music in a natural way, in a way that makes sense to me as a performer. Transparency, I want the audience to understand that relationship when I'm making those alterations to the music. And intuitiveness, it should be easy to pick up. Bigger and legato like that, or if they're moving their arm like that, or something with their fingers like this. All of those have some sort of understood meaning between the conductor and the performers. Whether it's taught or learned ahead of time, established ahead of time, or it's just mutually understood, doesn't really matter. The point is that we can communicate in a way. So the question is, can we design instruments with this in mind? And more specifically, can we design virtual instruments with this in mind? So if you imagine the front plane, a wall in front of the person performing, and it's divided into quadrants, right, like this. If I put my hand here, or if I put my hand here, it reacts differently. A possible application of this software is for people with disabilities. I was talking to a friend who I was telling about my project, and she mentioned that she has multiple sclerosis. And the left side of her body doesn't work in the way that it used to. She doesn't quite have the control. And so playing the piano is much more difficult now than it used to be. She basically can't use her left hand like she once was able to. So she and I and a lot of other people saw potential in this software for improving that. So I propose a framework basically consists of gestures and modes. We'll go through them all, but you can imagine, you know, like in lighting control, for example, in theatrical lighting, if I reach out and I grab the intensity of a light, I can move it down or I can move it up. Whatever, and it does the corresponding thing. Or like sound spatialization. So if there are speakers all around the room, right, and there's a sound that's playing only over there, and I reach here and I grab and I pull it across and it goes to that speaker, right? Those are really, really cool sort of future possibilities for this. And some people are actually doing that already in our studies.